Bhagavad Gita, 7th chapter, 1st verse, Shri Bhagavan Vacha, Maya Sakta Manaf Partha, Yogam Yunjan Madashrayah, Asamshayam Samagram Mam, Yatha Nyasyasi Tatshrunu. Shri Krishna, the Bhagavan said, Partha, O son of Pritha, Mai, on me, Asakta Manaha, with mind focused, Mad Ashrayah, taking refuge in me, Yogam, Yoga, Yunjan, practicing, Samagram, holy, Mam, me, Asamshayam, doubtless, Yatha, how, Nyasyasi, you shall know, Tat, that, Shrunu, you hear. The Lord said to Arjuna, in the previous chapter, the last verse, he says, Yoginam api sarvesham madgatena antaratmana shraddhavan bhajate yo mam same yukta tamo matah. So one who devotes oneself to me with shraddha, with complete sincerity of purpose, faith, etc., that person is considered to be the most focused by me. Now, that same teaching he is continuing. He is saying that a person who has got his mind asakta manaha, that means a person whose mind is focused on a particular thing, and that person takes mad ashraya, he takes ashraya or she takes ashraya in me. So that person, she takes ashraya in me and she is focused on me. Yogam, and yoga, yunjan, practicing, samagram, completely, that person knows me without doubt. So what is God? God is nothing but an understanding of ourself without doubt. A doubtless understanding of oneself is God. So why doubtless? We don't have any doubtless understanding of us. We think that I am the body and the mind. So that when we go to sleep, then we are unable to move the body, but still we have dream where we see so many things happening, then we have doubt. Then when we go to deep sleep, we have nice sleep, then we come back from deep sleep, we get up, we wake up, and then we say that I had a good sleep. But in deep sleep, can you think? You cannot think. So we have doubt. When you are young, you have some photographs of you, which you might be embarrassed. When you become older, if your mother brings that photograph, so you may be embarrassed in front of everybody. Don't show those photographs. I'm not properly dressed, etc. So that photograph. But can you identify yourself? Your body, can it be identified with that photograph, that body? No. So you have a small child, as a child you were in a kindergarten maybe. And that photograph you say, no, find me where I am. Why? Because it is not possible. You post that in Facebook and say, okay, find me. It's a competition. Something like that. Because that keeps on changing. So your idea about yourself is changing. You don't have a certain understanding of yourself, a firm understanding of yourself. Neither does a person have a firm understanding about others. Neither does the person have a firm understanding about the universe or the world. Everything is changing. Everything is changing. Science, today it will tell one thing, tomorrow it will tell another thing. Morning you will suddenly hear that coconut is bad for health. Evening it will suddenly become good for health. So when we were kids, there was this advertisement of Colgate. I'm nothing against that company, okay? Colgate toothpaste. So there used to be an old woman, Doordarshan time, Doordarshan. There was no other TV channel for some time at that time. So Doordarshan, then this old grandmother will come and she will take some charcoal and put it in her mouth. And then immediately there will be one dentist person coming. And he says, see, this charcoal you should not use. And they will show the mouth and there will be all cavities. Have you seen that advertisement? So cavities, there's a charcoal you should not use. And so Colgate, and then they will show the teeth and ting, like that one thing will come. And then they will say it is approved by the some dental association. God only knows what dental is. Anyway, now Colgate says that we have got charcoal in it. They say, so they are saying that charcoal is good for us. So we knew this all along. We knew this all along. Now they are saying Colgate has got salt in it. After some time, what will happen if you want to cook? If you don't have masala also, okay, you just take put toothpaste in that and it will be ready. Cooking will be over. Because they have got salt, they have got sugar, they have got pepper, everything will be there inside. So everything, understanding about ourselves, understanding about the world, understanding about animals, understanding about other living beings, keep on changes. This understanding keeps on changing. Why? Because these things are the nature of external world or unreal world, impermanent world is change. That is the only thing constant about something which is impermanent is change. That is the only thing which you can say with certainty. The only thing which you can say with certainty about your life is that you will die. Okay, all of you are going to die. So you should know what is that which is not going to die. Your body will die. If you think the body will not die, then you are doing a big mistake. So no matter how much beauty parlor you go, how much you do all your surgery, facial surgery and all that, whatever you do, only you will spend money, because nothing of that is going to remain. You will die one day. After that, what will happen? Your photo will, whatever makeup you did, that will be helpful for that photo which is going to be put on the frame. For that makeup, that photo. So if you just take one photo and keep it and say, iska frame bana, make frame of this, frame this photo, that is enough. So this idea keeps on changing. That is why Sri Krishna is saying, asamshayam nyasyasi, you should know me samagram, you will know me completely. And you will know me without doubt, asamshayam. So both are difficult in the world. Worldly knowledge, completely knowing anything is also difficult, and to know something without doubt is also difficult. It is difficult. So if you say, I know me completely, that means you are saying you know your mind completely. You don't know your mind completely because you have not got diabetes. Unless you get diabetes, how will you know them? Do you have a diabetes? Do you have diabetes? You don't have diabetes. Do you have diabetes? Anybody, you have diabetes? Nobody has got diabetes. Oh, you don't know your mind. Because the moment you will get diabetes, then you will know the mind. That rasagulla which you did not bother about suddenly becomes the greatest thing you want in the world. Then everywhere you will see only rasagulla. Or you will see jalebi. Or you will see gajar ka halwa. Suddenly then you know. You were thinking that your mind you have controlled. You are a very self-controlled person, etc. Either you should get diabetes or leopard, you should see leopard. You might be thinking, I am so fearless, etc. You meet a leopard, immediately you will understand that it is not the case. So we cannot know us. Why? Because we are trying to know that which is impermanent. Because mind is not our true nature. Body is not our true nature. Our true nature is Atman. If you try to know that, that will not change. So you will know that properly and you will know that without doubt. But there is another problem. Reality, to know reality completely is impossible. Even that reality which does not change, you cannot know it completely. So Sri Ramakrishna very nicely says, it is not necessary to know also. Suppose there is a hill of sugar, a small heap of sugar. An ant goes, does that ant need the whole heap? does not need. It just needs some. So ants can carry many times weight than their body weight. So many times, suppose their body weight is something, they can carry like 10-20 times weight of their body weight. So ants have been given this ability. So ants have this ability. But even then, will it need the whole heap of sugar? It does not need. It needs only some grains of sugar. That is enough for it. Similarly, for a person, we don't need to know God or reality completely, because it doesn't matter. That is why Sri Ramakrishna says, God is Akar, Sakar, and also so many other things. So God is with form, God is formless, but also many things. What many things is not specifying. So we don't need to know it. Like there is something called Andha Gaja Nyaya. That means blind people and elephant. Gaja means elephant and blind, Andha. So then Nyaya, there is a maxim. What is the maxim? That if many blind people go and see an elephant, will they understand that elephant? No, they will not. They will have their own understanding of elephant. Will it be true or false? It will be true, because they are seeing something and they are understanding. But will it be the complete understanding of elephant? No, it will not be. So somebody is touching the trunk and that is thinking that it is something. Somebody is touching the feet, legs, and thinking that elephant is, I am seeing some pillar. Somebody is touching the stomach part, body part, thinking that I am hitting some wall or something. Somebody is touching the tail, thinking that it is a rope. So everyone has got their own understanding. And all of that is true, but that is not the complete understanding. So it is called Andha Gaja Nyaya, the maxim of blind elephants. Blind and the elephant. So similarly, Sri Ramakrishna says, a person is there and is seeing, a person comes and sees a chameleon. So a chameleon is there on the tree, and that person is seeing it has turned green. Another person is seeing it has turned brown. Another person is seeing it has turned red. So everybody is confused. One person is sitting under the tree, and then that one person gets confused, goes and asks that person who is sitting under the tree, that tell me, what is the color of this chameleon? And then that person says, it is red, it is yellow, it is all these colors, but it has got some other colors also, or it can become colorless also. The idea is, God, we don't need to know God completely, but we can know us, ourselves completely. But what part of ourselves we can know completely? Not the part which changes. That you cannot know completely. And it is not useful also. By knowing it, nothing will happen. So that part which does not change, that part which is constant, even when you were a child, when you were an infant, you were probably wearing no dress, birthday dress. That part is true even when you were like that. That part of your personality is true even when you were in kindergarten. Even when you will be on your deathbed, even then that part will be true. So that part, that constant part of your personality which does not change, that one has to know. And that one can know without doubt and without any remainder. That means samagram, completely, wholly you can know that. And you can know asamshayam, without any doubt. Samshaya means doubt. Asamshaya means without any doubt. So, but what does a person need to have? Asakta manaha. Should be focused. Only a focused mind can lead to that kind of understanding. If your mind is not focused, you will not know. So, whatever we meditate upon, we become like that. Whatever we meditate upon, we become like that. Why is our mind not focused? Because we meditate upon things which constantly change. So if you meditate upon things which constantly, you stand in front of your mirror. Do you stand in front of mirror? And you try to do some makeup. That will change. That is why your mind is not focused. Because that is going to change. Your body is changing. You have seen your body is constantly changing. What is that which is not changing? The idea of I. always I, you have this idea. Your name might have changed. Somebody might be calling Gullu, something like that in house, no? Pinky, something like that. But you have got a good formal name, you have got a nickname, then other people will keep some other nickname for you. But all these will change. But that consciousness of I, even a person who is suffering from Alzheimer's, complete Alzheimer's, they forget about everything. They forget about the height, they forget that a knife can cut, everything they forget. But even that person does not forget I. That I consciousness, complete amnesia, where a person completely loses all memory, does not forget the memory of I. So this I is that which is constantly remaining. Now we have to hold on to I and understand what is it which is behind this I. I is definitely not this body, because this body is constantly changing, but I is not changing. That is called in Sanskrit, Sanskrita, it is called Aham Graha Upasana. The meditation on I, holding on to I, you do meditation. Then you think, what is it? What is it which is giving me this idea of I, which is not changing at all? Even if a person goes into coma and comes out, even then that is not changing. What is it? So that you think. So that which is not changing, you will come to know. Not only you will come to know, you will come to know without any doubt, and you will come to know without any remainder. You will wholly, completely, you will come to know. There will be nothing remaining to know. That is the idea. But for that, asakta manaha, you should be focused on me. If you are focused on me, then you will be knowing that. And so, whatever you need to know, tat shrunu, listen to me. So focus, if you are focused on me, you will also listen to me. So you should listen to me. Because you are focused, you will listen to me. If you are not focused, you will not listen. Me means Lord, Sri Krishna. So you will not listen. Why will you not listen? When are we, suppose I were to tell you, there is a method by which every day you can get 10 crore of rupees. Already some people have stopped like that. Their heart also has stopped beating like that. No, 10 crore daily. How? So you see, immediately you become focused. Why? Because your mind is there. You want 10 crores. 10 crore, 100 crores be though. What is there? Let it come. So your mind is there. But if I tell you there is a way by which you can have no sorrow, you can go beyond sorrow. So first thing which will come into your mind is probably he is talking about alcohol or drugs. Like that something will think. Having drugs, no sorrow will be there. Sorrow will come after some time, it will come. Not only for you, for other people who are around you. But that, when you know that this is something philosophy, and you say, oh, this is simply philosophy, this is not going to happen. Because you don't think that it is practical. Because you don't think that it is possible. So you will not be focused. But if it is possible, how is it possible that something which is not possible is being talked about by so many people? For so many centuries, Buddha came 2500 years ago. Sri Krishna came 5000 years ago. So how is it that people are still talking about this? People still are saying that I have got that. So how is it possible? I am not talking about people who pose or claim to have got that. But really people have got that. That type of people are also there. I am not talking about frauds. I am talking about genuine people who have got it. So how is it not true? It is true. So if you really want to get rid of sorrow, then you will automatically, just like if I tell you every day if you do this, you will get 10 crore every day, like automatically you will get focus. Similarly, you will get focus if you know, if you want to get rid of sorrow. Now why are we not focused? Because we don't want to get rid of sorrow. We like being unhappy. We want to be unhappy. Because we don't want to give the price for not being unhappy. Simple. The less and less desires you have, the more and more happy, and for longer time you will be happy. Because your happiness is not dependent on a particular thing.
So this is the whole idea. This is the idea not only about of spiritual or religious life, but this is the idea also of science. The question will come in the second shloka. Jnanam teham savijnanam idam vakshyami asheshatah yat jnatva neha bhuyo anyat jnatavyam avashishyate. Aham te, I will tell to you savijnanam combined with experience or realization, idam jnanam, this knowledge, asheshatah, completely, vakshyami, shall tell. What kind of knowledge? Yat jnatva, knowing which, iha, in this world, that means in this life, bhuyaha, anything other than that, more than that, anyat, anything else, jnatavyam, to be known, na avashishyate, will not remain. So, Sri Krishna is telling Arjuna, you listen now, focus here and listen. Just like a teacher would say that focus, attend, give attention here and listen. And he says, you listen and then what? Completely. So what does that completely mean? What is our true nature? Atman, Brahman, which is Ananta, means infinite. Infinite, it has got infinite greatness, it has got infinite strength, infinite power, infinite grace, and all those infinite things. So that infinite thing also, which does not have any boundary, even that you will know completely. That is the idea. Even that you will know completely. So, savijnanam. So here he is saying that I will tell you that knowledge with realization, not bookish knowledge. I have read in that book, I have read in, not like that. Suppose you want to make pulao. Do you eat pulao? Do you know how to prepare pulao? Can other people eat if you prepare?
Yes, of course.
Of course. Yeah. Depends. So, if you want to make pulao, you go to YouTube. And then you see a recipe. You write down the recipe. Will you be able to make pulao by that? No, you have to make pulao. You have to get those ingredients. You have to do things. And first of all, you have to light the stove. So there is this silly but famous joke that a person put all the ingredients and then nothing was happening because lighting the stove did not do. It was not written in the recipe. So like that. So you have to light the stove. So practically you have to do it. And finally after the pulao is done, will it bring you any joy? You have to eat it. Only then it will bring you joy. So here he is saying savijnanam combined with realization. It is not just that I have made the pulao or I know the theory, I don't know the practice. No, it's not like that. I have, do you know why now so many bridges are falling every day? Recently also in Kolkata one fell. Are you from Kolkata?
No.
So, do you know why bridges are falling every day?
They are not making it properly.
No, because the people who teach in engineering colleges, they know nothing about how to make a bridge. Okay, engineering college in India, if you meet anybody, anywhere, that person will be an engineer. Okay, so and there are so many unemployed engineers in India. As there are so many engineering colleges without students. So engineering is the highest cause of unemployment in India. Agar berozgar hona hai to engineering padho. That kind of a situation. If you want to become unemployed, study engineering. So now this engineering college, people are teaching, they know nothing about the bridges and all that. They have not made bridges. So that is why the person they will teach also, the person, if that person learn civil engineering, goes to make a bridge, that bridge will follow. Same is true with all other branches of knowledge. A person who has not done it, for example, accounts. Many people teach accounts. They know nothing about accounts. They have not done accounts in the real world. So they don't know that, am I not telling it properly? Am I not right? So they will not know what are the challenges in the real world accounting. And then they will simply teach some bookish knowledge. So that is why here Sri Krishna is making it specific. Savijnanam. It is with realization. Similar idea we get in the life of Sri Ramakrishna. When Sri Ramakrishna was there and Swami Vivekananda, at that time Narendranath Datta, he saw, he read so much, and from childhood he was worshipping deities, etc. And then he read Western philosophy. Then he thought that, where is it? I'm not getting anybody who has experienced this knowledge. So he went on asking people, have you seen God? And everybody were telling so many things, but no one could say that I have seen God. And you see, it is difficult to tell lies to such a person. One might ask this question. Now also many people claim to have seen God. If you open YouTube, everybody has seen God. In fact, you get very few people who have the honesty to say, I have not realized God. Or truly who has realized, even to get those kind of people, it is very difficult. So, but why couldn't anybody tell lie to Swami Vivekananda, at that time Narendranath Datta? Because a person who is sincerely asking, it is very difficult to lie to that person. And that person will also see through your lie. So he went everywhere and he was asking. Finally he met Sri Ramakrishna, and Sri Ramakrishna, he asked the same question. And he said, not only I have seen it, but I can show you also. And I see it more clearly than I see you. I see God more clearly than I see all these objects of this universe. So savijnanam idam, the same way how Arjuna is taught by Sri Krishna so many years ago, 5000 years ago, he is saying this knowledge is not theory, just not theory, it is a practical knowledge. I have realized it. You have come to Mayavati, now somebody says, Mayavati, there is no place like that, there is only that stupid politician. There is no place like Mayavati. Okay, so then you say, no, I have gone there. I have seen the place. How are you saying there is no place? I have seen it. So practical experience has no parallel. There is nothing which can surpass experience, because that experience is your experience. You cannot say, if somebody says, what is PhD, and you don't know that PhD is Pizza Hut delivery, for instance. So Pizza Hut delivery, then you say, hey, PhD, what Pizza Hut delivery? There is nothing called PhD Pizza Hut delivery. If you have ordered it through phone or something, they will give you in a box, and there it will be written PhD. It is written by them. So there you will, PhD, Pizza Hut delivery. So that is experience. Now somebody says, kuch bhi bolte ho, so you tell whatever you want. No, it's not like that. It's experience. I have ordered, I have got that pizza, and I have eaten it, and it was nice, and so I know PhD means Pizza Hut delivery. So everybody can do PhD, see? Very easy. So like that, savijnanam idam, combined with experience, realization. And I will tell you, aseshatah, I will tell you this knowledge completely. I'm not going to give you half knowledge. How does somebody tell something completely? How is it even possible? It is not possible. This knowledge you get completely, not because somebody tells you, but somebody tells you the path to get that knowledge completely. For example, do you have a complete knowledge of sleep? What is your name?
Abhishek.
So do you have a complete knowledge of sleep?
I may have, but I won't be able to tell that knowledge.
No. Have you completely experienced sleep?
Yes, I have experienced.
That's what I'm saying. So you have completely experienced sleep. But if somebody asks you, there are so many people who work on sleep. There are so many scientists who work on the phenomenon of sleep. They work on that, they do study, research, etc. So, but that knowledge you might not be having. But you have experienced sleep, and so you know what sleep is. So this knowledge, but even this knowledge is a knowledge which you get through your mind. But there is a knowledge, there is only one kind of knowledge, which you get not through the mind or through the senses. Most of the knowledge or all knowledge in this world you get through the senses and the mind. But there is one law. So this senses and the mind, whatever knowledge you get, realization you get, it is called paroksha anubhuti. Para means external in this context, and aksha means senses, sense organs, other organs. Aksha means eyes, but it represents all sense organs including the mind. And anubhuti means realization. So experience through external sense organs is paroksha anubhuti. But the experience of God or experience of Atman, your true nature, which will not change, is aparoksha anubhuti, which is an experience which is not through the sense organs and the mind. It is beyond that. That you get. When you get that, you have no doubt. And you get it completely. Because that is your version of sleep. You know what happens to you when you sleep. Now, no matter whatever a person will, no matter even if you watch the movie called Inception, in which, have you watched that movie? Huh. So that movie basically is based on a book by a person called Carlos Castaneda. He wrote many books. The main book was called The Art of Dreaming. Don't read that book because many people have become mad reading that book, trying to practice what has been written. So there he says that you can change your dream. And you have seen the movie, so there that is the dream architect is there who will change the dream, etc. So even though a person like somebody, a dream architect from Inception comes and tells you, say Leonardo DiCaprio comes and tells you, is it Leonardo DiCaprio? Yeah. He comes and tells you that this is how you can change the, but that is not your experience. So you will say, no, such things don't happen. You might have made a $1 billion movie, but a multi-billion dollar movie, but it does not happen to me in my life. So that is not my experience. So your experience of sleep, you know completely. Similarly, this knowledge of Atman, you get going beyond the mind and senses, and that knowledge is your knowledge. Okay. For example, much has been written and much will be continued to be written about love. Okay. But everybody has their own experience of love. Right? Can it be reproduced? Can it be replicated? It cannot be. For some persons, that love may be like spending so much money on mobile phone or getting mobile phone recharge, or going to some coffee shop, etc. That is your experience of love. Is it not? So that experience cannot be replicated because it is your version of love. His version of love will be something, he belongs to a different era altogether. So his version of love will be something else. His version of love will be something else, and so on and so forth. But none of these versions can be replicated because it is a unique experience. Every experience that way. But more unique than all these experiences is the experience of knowing your own self or knowing God or Brahman. And that is why asheshatah bhakshyami, I will tell you completely. So empirical knowledge, sense knowledge is not possible to be told completely. Only when it becomes an experience based thing, then it is complete. Okay. You don't know everything about love. You don't know. Nobody can know. But you know your aspect of love. What love means to you, that you know. Right? So that is the thing. But here, this is not a sense-based knowledge. It's not a sensory knowledge. It is not a sensate experience. It is a supra-sensory knowledge. It is beyond senses, beyond mind. And so, Sri Krishna says, I will tell you, just like Sri Ramakrishna said, same way as Sri Krishna said to Arjuna, Sri Ramakrishna said to Vivekananda, that I will tell you this experience. I can show it to you also. Vakshyami. And not only that, yat jnatva, knowing which, iha bhuvayaha anyat jnatavyam na avashishyate. There will be nothing to be known in this world. So nowadays, even if you go and get a job, you constantly have to study. Particularly if you are in fields like information technology, IT, you have to constantly study. This course, that certification, this programming, that something you have to constantly keep on studying. If you are a doctor also, you have to study. Otherwise, you will not know what is happening in the field. Same with lawyer, etc. Basically, you have to constantly study. Particularly people who make money out of other people's suffering, they have to study more. Because they, what in Hindi we say, no, chuna lagate hain. They, not all, but most of them, they try to, what do? You are a teacher, okay. So teacher also has to study. So much you have to study. You have to study. So doctor has to study, because the doctor will say, I know better than the other doctor. to prove that you have to study. Lawyer says, I know better than the other lawyer. A chartered accountant also says the same thing. I know, oh, you went to that chartered accountant, that fellow knows nothing. I am a better chartered accountant, is it not? Then you have to study. Constantly you have to study. So many circulars will come that this, you have to keep on studying.
In that way, everybody of us.
That is the sign of the empirical knowledge of the unreal, that you think you know better than other people because it is constantly changing. But some people think more than other people. Like for example, suppose a panwala is there. What will the panwala think? That I know better than other people. That will not think more. But a doctor, first thing you go to a doctor, even to that fellow, that is why all these things has happened. Now you see, and lawyer will say, don't go to that fellow, has spoiled your case, and you see, I will now somehow save you, protect you, I am your savior, etc. But even they have to constantly study. But Sri Krishna is saying here, yat jnatva bhuyah, more than that, anyat jnatavyam na avashishyate. That means there will be nothing to study more. Knowing which, you will have nothing else to know. That is being told by Sri Krishna. So, everybody has to constantly study, continuing education, continuing professional education.
But these students are not continuing studying.
No, they are not.
And he has told that you cannot know the whole thing. And he said nothing else will be.
No. Earlier he did not say, Earlier he said, Samagram you will know completely. I told you that he is talking about the knowledge of self, and that you can know completely. But knowledge of empirical things will not be. I was giving you the comparison. Knowledge of empirical things, worldly things, things that change, you cannot know completely.
When you told her that one and cannot take the whole, understand the whole thing.
No, completely means not what is there outside, but your version of it. Atma you can know completely, not God. That is Sri Ramakrishna's example, that we need to know only what we need. That means our idea of Atman. Okay, you don't need to know God. So some other person will have another idea. Another idea means it is not something external. Your experience and my experience will be different. It will always be different. It is different also when it comes to empirical things, when it comes to sensory experience. Your experience and my experience is different. So it is also same for experience of Atman, self-experience. So that is why I put that empirical knowledge you cannot know completely. But self-knowledge you can know completely. But the true nature of reality, ultimate reality, I cannot say I have known God completely. That I cannot say. But I can say I have known myself completely. So that is what Sri Krishna is saying. And he is saying, knowing which you will not be, there is nothing more to be known. There will be nothing more to be known. Anyah and nothing more. Anyat something else and bhuyah more. So nothing more to be known. Avashishyate, it will not remain. This question was asked in the Upanishad by, there is an Upanishad called Mundaka Upanishad. So there is somebody, a householder, a grihastha, his name is Shaunaka. He goes to a guru whose name is Angirasa. He goes and asks this question, Kasminno Bhagavo Vijnate Sarvamidam Vijnatam Bhavati Iti. What is it, knowing which all this can be known? This is the question. What is it, one thing, knowing which all this can be known? But that is the spiritual question. That is the religious question. But there is a scientific question also. Same question. What do you study?
Science.
What science?
BCM, basically.
No, you are in school, is it?
No, college.
What do you study? BSc.
Yes.
So in science, in physics, there is a question. In advanced physics, higher physics, there is this question. So this question was originally asked by Albert Einstein. What is that question? At that time, we knew four forces of nature. There is something called gravitational force. There is something called electromagnetic force. Then there is something called weak force. That is the force. What is weak force?
Van der Waal force.
Weak force is the force by which the electron in the outermost orbit of an atom is held by the nucleus. That is the weak force. And what is the strongest force? Strongest force is by which subnuclear particle are held in the nucleus. Okay. So, of an atom. So, these four forces we know, four categories of forces or four kinds of forces we know. But Albert Einstein asked the famous question, give me one force which will explain all these four forces. Then what happened? Then now we know that electromagnetic force, gravitational force is also a kind of electromagnetic force. So gravitational force also has come into electromagnetic force. Now we know three basic forces of the universe. So again, people are searching to know the one force which will explain all these three. So knowing which, you know everything. That is the scientific version. So for that, what they are doing? There are a lot of studies. There are studies of superstring theory. Then it is called M theory. Then again now superstring theory. Then there is now gravitational waves. Or there is something called multiverse, parallel universe, etc. All these studies, the goal of the study is to find out that one force which will explain all the basic three forces, fundamental forces of the universe. Now same question is asked here. Knowing which, you know everything. Buddha had the same question. He saw suffering. What kind of four kinds of suffering he saw? He saw the one day in the afternoon, when everybody had nicely, you know, had all the dance and all the drinking and everybody was sleeping, then he was kept inside his small. When we read tales, it is as though his father was a great king and all. Not like that. He was a small king in Lumbini. If you go to Nepal, you can see that place. Lumbini. And so he was lying down and he was seeing all these people with all their dresses and all in not very good shape. And they were all lying. Suddenly he woke up in the afternoon. He woke up and he saw that, oh, now I have got chance. Then he called this charioteer, driver, chauffeur, Chandana. Then he went and sat on the chariot and then went outside. And then he saw an old person going. Then he asked Chandana, what has happened to him? Because he did not see all this suffering. He was protected from not seeing the suffering. How did that they achieve that? That itself is a big question. And nowadays it is impossible because anybody will go to iPad and everything is there. So anyway, they achieved it and then they asked, he asked Chandana, will you become old like that? He said, yes. Will I become old? Yes. Then he again saw a person who is ill. So then he said, what happened? This person is ill. Oh, will you become ill? Yes. Will I become ill? Yes. Then he again saw a dead body was being carried. What has happened to that person? He has died. Oh, will you die? Yes. Will I die? Yes. Then finally he saw one person, shaven head, and he was going nicely, happily, joyfully. So he said, what has happened? He has found the truth. He is a monk. He has found the truth. Can you find the truth? If I try, I can also find. Can I find? Yes. That's all. So there is suffering and there is a way out of suffering. That is Buddha. So what is that way which will put an end, put a full stop to all suffering? That is what Buddha realized. And the day he realized, 3 days he could not stop walking under a tree, under a Bodhi tree. That is the people tree, no? So he was constantly moving up and down, and then he realized he has to give this knowledge to the entire world. So there is a force or there is a knowledge which if you know, then you know all that is to know. So bhuyah anyat jnatavyam na avashishyate. There is nothing else to know. So Sri Krishna says, okay, I will teach you that knowledge. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat.